Hello students, in the last class we have discussed about the basic definition of division ring and field. So now here I am going to discuss some of the example of field, and here I have written one question, prove that this is the unsolved question that I have forwarded to you. I have sent many solved question also or unsolved question also. Out of these unsolved question, I am taking first question. So see the question. Prove that set Q dash, what kind of a set is there? It contains all such kind of elements. Means A plus root B. Here A and B belongs to Q. What is Q here? Q is a set of rational. And we have to prove this is a field. Now this is very important question for you people. Why? Because you know that if you will go through the definition that we have discussed in the last class, it was the commutative division ring is a field. So you must know what is the meaning of division ring. Already we have discussed this also, and you know it must be a ring and it must have the proper zero divisor. It should not have any proper zero divisor. So why this question is important? In this question you will understand what are the main properties are required to verify whether any set is a field or not. So before starting this question, I want to clear that means we have total 11 properties that we have to check whether the given set is a field or not. So what are the 11 properties? I will start one by one. So start with the first property. The first property is closed under addition. So let's take the two like, so let's take two elements like A comma B belongs to Q dash, or any A comma B belongs to Q dash. So what will be A and B? A will be of kind, this means A1 plus root 2B1, and B will be A2 plus root 2B2. Here A1, B1, A2, B2 belongs to Q. So even you can take one more C also, because we have to take this A and B again and again. So I am going to take only once. Okay, even you can take C also here. You can take C also, and C will be of A3 root 2 B3. So A3 and B3 also belongs to Q. Now the first property says that, the first property says that if you have a b belongs to Q dash, then we have to check whether a plus b is also belongs to Q dash. So let's check it. So a1 plus root 2 b1 plus a2 root 2 b2. So you know that a1 plus a2, okay, you will get common from these two terms, and root 2 is common. So you have a B1 plus B2. And you know that sum of two rational is again a rational, means A1 plus A2 and B1 plus B2 is again a rational, implies that this is also belongs to Q dash. So therefore, Q dash is closed under addition. So this is the one property that we have to prove, first property. Okay, so next property is the associative property, property number 2. Already we have taken A, B, C belongs to Q dash. Then for associative property we have to prove A plus B plus C must be is equal to A plus B plus C. Now if you will take left hand side, you have A is a1 plus root 2b1. So this you will get when you will add a, this is b, this is c, when you will add this and this, and after that you will add, you will get this. Now if you will take right hand side in the same way, you will get a plus b plus c. If you will add first two, and you will get same thing, means a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus root 2 b1 plus b2 plus b3. So both sides are equal, therefore q dash is associative under multiplication. So third property that we have to check for the addition is basically the identity. So if you will take a is equal to a plus root 2 b belongs to q dash, then there exist 0. 0 means 0 plus root 2 0 belongs to q dash, such that a plus 0 is equal to a and is equal to 0 plus a. So therefore 0 is an additive identity of q dash. So the next is the inverse. So fourth property is the inverse. For every a belongs to q dash, a is the same here, there exist a b, means there exist a b such that belongs to q dash, such that a plus b is equal to its additive identity. And what will be b? B will be 0 minus a, and it is minus a. So it is very easy, you need not to verify it is exist, because this, if a is like a plus root 2 b, then minus a, minus a, minus root 2 b, and both minus a and minus 2 b also belongs to q. So this is also belongs to q dash. So therefore minus a is the inverse of a. So inverse is also exist. So the fifth property is basically commutative under addition, means if a comma b, for every a b belongs to q dash, implies a plus b is equal to b plus a. I think is need not to check, it is very much clear, both sides are equal, then this property is also hold, addition is commutative. Now let's move to the next. So these five properties for the addition. So next five properties will be for the multiplication. So if a comma b belongs to r, sorry, q dash, so here a is equal to a plus a1 plus root 2 b1, and b is equal to a2 plus root 2 b2, and then we have to check what a multiply b must be belongs to q dash. So here a into b will be a1 plus root 2 b1 multiply a2 plus root 2 b2. When you will multiply, a1 will multiply with a2, then a1 with this, you will get root 2 a1 b2, then this with this, you will get root 2 b1 a2, then root 2 into root 2 means 2 b1 into b2. So these two terms are without root, So you will take a1, a2 plus 2, b1, b2 plus. So you will take root 2 common from these two terms. What you will get? A1, b2 plus a2, b1. And you know that if you will take two rational number, a1 and a2 are the rational number, then product will be rational number, this will be the rational number, and sum again. So this is rational number, and same here, this is a rational number. So this implies the whole belongs to Q dash, correct? So therefore Q dash, so Q dash is closed under multiplication. So next property is, if you have a multiplication means associative under multiplication, if you have a ABC belongs to Q dash, then you have to prove A into B into C must be is equal to A into B into C. So because here the multiplication is very lengthy, I can do it, even you people can do at your end, but when you will multiply B and C and then you will multiply with A, when you multiply A with B and then you will multiply A, you will get both sides are equal. So after that, when you verify it, you will check, you will say Q dash is associative under multiplication. So eighth property that you have to verify, it is the multiplicative identity. So for every A belongs to Q dash, there exist one which is equal to 1 plus root 2 0 belongs to Q dash, such that if you will multiply A with 1 means you will get A, and if you will multiply 1 with A you will get again A. So here 1 is the multiplicative identity of Q dash. So multiplicative identity is also holds the 9th property that you have to check. It is additive inverse. It's a very simple thing, means if you want to check whether additive inverse exists or not, so you will follow the procedure. A, for every A belongs to Q dash, if there exist a B belongs to Q dash, such that A into B is equal to 1. 1 is the multiplicative identity. So now you can find the value of B. So B will be 1 over A here. What is A? You know that A plus root 2 B. So now you can rationalize it. A minus root 2 B upon A minus root 2 B. So when you will this into this, A plus B, A minus B, you have A square minus root 2 B square. So what you will get next? So you have A minus root 2 B in the numerator. So A minus root 2 B, you have A square minus 2 B square. So what you will do here? A upon A square minus 2 B square minus root 2 B upon A square minus 2 B square. So if you will see, this is a rational number and this is a rational number. Therefore, this is belongs to Q dash. So this B is equal to A upon A square minus 2B square minus root 2 B upon A square minus 2B square is the multiplicative inverse of A. Okay, so this it is also holds. Now the property number 10 that we have to, it is the multiplicative, means if you have A into B, A B belongs to Q dash, then A into B is equal to B into A, means this is the commutative under multiplication, and you can verify very easily both sides will be equal. So if this property, this is also holds, means it is commutative under multiplication. So the 11th property that we have to check, it is a distributive law. Means if you have A, B, C belongs to Q dash, then A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC, and this is also very easy. You can take ABC that we have taken earlier, you can verify this property also, so it is also true. So if you will go through this question again, you have to prove 11 properties, and now things are very clear. So if you want to prove a ring, the given set is a ring, then there are 4-8 property. You can go through the previous videos, but here it is very much clear. If you have to prove any set is a field, then you have to prove these 11 properties. Now I will discuss one more. So there is one more question that I want to discuss here. The question is, we have to prove n is a set of natural number with addition and multiplication operation is not a field. So if you want to prove any set is a, any algebraic structure is a field, then you have to verify all these 11 properties. And if you have to prove any set is not a field, then you have to give only at least one reason why it is not a field. Means you have to give only that reason, that particular property which is not true for the given set. So there are many reasons this is not a, now here I am going to discuss only one, because if you will take any A belongs to N, means a natural number, so you cannot have any element, any, because you do not have any additive identity, the property number third of the field, means because 0 is not a part of, doesn't belong to N, so you do not have any other element that you will add, that you will add with A and you will get again A. Definitely it will be 0, but 0 is not a part, means no additive identity, so therefore it is not a field. So here I have given only one reason, so I hope you understand the today's topic, and I will come up with some more question, and you go through that the file that I have sent to you. If you have any doubts and any question that you are not able to solve it, share with me. I will try to solve it in the next lecture. Thank you very much.